So we have 5 powers returning from Psychonauts 1. Things that Raz now is second nature to him. Got levitation, telekinesis, psi blast, and pyro. And then you've got clairvoyance.
There's kind of 2 main things that levitation power lets you do. One is the levitation ball.
It's actually meant to be like a little thought bubble that kind of materializes, and then he yanks that down and it becomes this little ball that he can stand on and then roll around on as though it was like a circus bear rolling on a little ball.
Levitation is basically the run button for Psychonauts 2.
It's a pretty like powerful complement to his already agile moveset.
The other aspect of levitation power is the float balloon, which kind of lets you extend the distance on a jump. So after doing your jump, you can bring out the balloon and kind of glide downwards to get a little bit more distance.
Telekinesis, which allows you to move things with your mind.
Yeah, so the way telekinesis functions in Psychonauts is that it allows Raz to pretty much grab any loose object in the environment and then carry it around and then throw it at something, usually an enemy.
I really like the feeling of grabbing and like throwing things, especially in combat. Like when you get the weight from the regret and you just throw it at something, it's like, it's one of the sweetest feelings.
Different enemies in Psychonauts 2 are more susceptible to certain powers. So you may find that using telekinesis against sensors is like a really good strategy. Using telekinesis against another enemy might not be so effective.
There are some other like areas where you have puzzles where you're grabbing things and then plugging them into other objects.
Psi Blast is Raz's mental power to take a big ball of psychic energy, concentrate it, and then blast it at an enemy or object to, I don't know, maim or kill it. I don't know.
Essentially mind bullets.
His brain gun.
Okay, so you got pyrokinesis, where you burn stuff. Clairvoyance allows you to see yourself through others' eyes.
Clairvoyance is Raz's ability to sort of see through another character's eyes, and that character can be friend or foe.
You may kind of walk up to NPCs in the world and use clairvoyance to spot some secret that they know about that you can't see otherwise.
When we really started to focus on like you using it to learn more about the characters in the world, then the life of clairvoyance really started to come together.
So Raz learns 3 major new powers in this game. The first big power that you learn is actually mental connection.
Yeah, one of the things that makes Raz special among his other psychic interns is that he is an acrobat, right? He's a trained circus performer. And so a lot of times he will use powers in ways that his fellow interns are surprised by.
I said connect with the idea, not jump inside it like a hamster ball.
Mental connection is Raz's ability to focus on a thought in someone's mind, making a connection to it, and actually travel to it. And they're like little nodes in someone's mind.
Which for traversal allows you to zip around a battlefield and also do more vertical traveling in the environment.
It's a really dynamic and kinetic way to move through a level really fast, while also making a connection between 2 thoughts that can change the mind of the person you're in.
And then also in combat, it allows him to get in close.
In combat, mental connection can be used to grapple to an enemy. If it's a smaller enemy, it pulls the enemy to you. But if you're fighting a much bigger enemy, like the judge, you'll get pulled over to that enemy.
And later on, with upgrades and pins, you can add on melee punch or modify it in various ways, like making it root enemies to the ground or drain their health.
In this game, Raz learns the power of time bubble.
The new power that you learn in our sort of psychedelic brain in a jar.
Which allows him to change the movement of time of a localized object.
I really like time bubble and how that feels in the world.
It's super useful both for puzzles, for platforming, making moving platforms easier to jump on.
If there's like a really fast spinning thing that you want to like be able to climb on rather than getting smashed.
Once you get that power, the world kind of opens up to you and gameplay changes a lot.
So in combat, you might use it to slow down an enemy to give you more time to fight some other enemies.
Particularly when you're dealing with panic attack, which is very fast and frantic. So you can slow them down using the time bubble ability in order to like get hits in. This also kind of interconnects with the mental connection ability. You can time bubble someone from far away and then pull Raz towards the enemy very quickly in order to do a strike.
From Cassiopeia, Raz learns this ability to summon an archetype from deep in his unconscious.
As you're charging it up, you actually see it sort of draw in with this tiny little pen.
In Raz's case, he summons a warrior spirit to help him.
His warrior spirit is maybe not that focused.
He's like your eager little brother, because he's always kind of like being really cute and just super excited to do everything that you're doing.
He just sort of became this silly light version of Raz.
Within combat, it's actually super useful because as we start to get to the later levels, the combats are larger. We have a large palette of enemies that are available. And it's nice to have a little friend that can basically distract them and pull them off so Raz can focus.
For like puzzles, you can tell him to like pass through some really skinny bars that you might not fit through yourself, but he can because he's just a piece of paper and can like sidle through it sideways, right?
One fun fact about the archetype that Raz projects into the world is that it's a little bit of a, for fans of Invader Zim, a reunion of that cast because we have Richard Horowitz, the excellent actor playing Raz.
Sup, clone?
And then we have Ricky Simmons, who played Gurr.
Aw, that's cute. My clone thinks he's real.
Back together again and have a relationship that is similarly fraught with ups and downs.
It's a nice little Easter egg for like the people who are fans of both franchises.